Hi, I'm Joe Layden, the Moving Picture Blog and Houston Community College's Town and Country Branch. Well, think of it as Serpico meets the French Connection in New Jack City. It's American Gangster, a true crime story with an A-list cast and epic ambitions. Of course, it's not just the facts, ma'am. In fact, some people have already complained that names and places have been changed and, well, some stuff just got made up in order to protect the innocent and, well, maybe even whitewash the guilty. But if you're willing to accept an enjoyably pulpy melodrama with a gritty 70s flavor, well, I think you'll find that American Gangster can be enjoyed as something more than just another guilty pleasure. Oscar winner Denzel Washington plays Frank Lucas, the Harlem-based drug kingpin who rose to the top of the underworld by smuggling in uncut heroin from Southeast Asia during the height of the Vietnam War. And Oscar winner Russell Crowe, well, see, I told you this was an A-list cast. Crowe plays Richie Roberts, an incorruptible New Jersey cop who's determined to take Lucas down. Lucas sees himself as a great American success story and a dedicated family man. And truth to tell, it sometimes seems like director Ridley Scott wants us to see him that way too. Fortunately, there's the potent counterbalance of Crowe as the cop who sees the drug lord as a death-dealing scourge who must be stopped. There's a terrific supporting cast, including Josh Brolin as a dirty cop and Armand Asante as a suave mafioso. And the 70s period flavor is evoked with both broad strokes and subtle touches. I was particularly impressed by the way Ridley Scott repeatedly keeps news about the then-current Vietnam War flickering in the background or percolating below the surface throughout much of the movie. It's as though Scott wanted to suggest that maybe, just maybe, the career of Frank Lucas, a man who smuggled his heroin into this country from Asia with help from corrupt U.S. military personnel, was collateral damage caused by the Vietnam War. We travel from Vietnam to Afghanistan and Iraq and Iran in another new drama, Lions for Lambs. It's an ambitious and intelligent drama directed by Robert Redford, who also plays one of the lead roles. And while I can't say it's entirely successful, I have to give Redford credit for raising some questions for which he can't provide easy answers. Redford plays a political science professor who's trying to convince a promising student to stop being such a self-satisfied slacker and to actually engage in the politics of war and peace. Trouble is, the professor may have been a little too convincing with a couple of other students, played by Michael Peña and Derek Luke. They got so engaged that they enlisted in the military. Meanwhile, back in the States, a reporter played by Meryl Streep is trying to get the inside story behind the story from a rising young Republican congressman played by Tom Cruise, who thinks an unpopular war can still regain public favor, with a little help from the same media folks who prepared America for the war in the first place. The scenes with Streep and Cruise are really the best parts of Lions for Lambs. Their verbal jousting may not be terribly dramatic, but it's thought-provoking and sometimes genuinely witty. Lions for Lambs certainly isn't great cinema. But you know what? It's a welcome break from popcorn movies that don't provide anything like food for thought. I'm Joe Layden. It's been good talking with you.